Stand by for words from the commanding officer.
Hello, CFAY. I'm Captain Dave Owen, and welcome to Commander's Corner. It's the 24th of September, 2012. I'm going to have some special guests on here pretty soon, but first I'm going to go through some announcements. The first thing I need to talk about, not a good thing. Over the weekend, we had two more DUIs, bringing up to 22 for the year. The one individual actually blew a .116. He definitely was pickled, and he was operating a vehicle when he got caught coming through the front gate. I can't say it enough times. If you're going to indulge in the ignorant oil, do not get behind the wheel of a car. We've had way too many of these already this year. Let's not have any more. So have a plan. Get a designated driver. Drink soda pop. Walk. Take a taxi. Whatever it takes, do not get behind the wheel of a car after drinking, especially after you have drank a lot. Starting today, the Vehicle Registration Office, the VRO, has some new hours of operations. It's going to be open from 8 to 11 and then from noon to 3:30, Monday through Friday. So those new hours of operations down at the Vehicle Registration Office. Tomorrow, on the 25th of September, there's going to be a big demonstration down near the front gate. Over at Verney Park, there's going to be approximately 2,000 people. They're anticipating a rally there. Then they're going to do a march that's going to go past the base by Kearney Gate. We do expect some closures at Kearney Gate tomorrow between 7 and 8 p.m. So try to stay away from Kearney Gate tomorrow on the 25th between 7 and 8 p.m. On the 30th, there will be the normal monthly demonstrations and protests. Those only involve about 50 people, and we don't expect any closures. But on Sunday afternoon, you will also see some protesters down by the main gate. Got a couple 5K runs coming up. Here on the 26th, we have the Suicide Prevention 5K. That starts at 11:30 at Purdy Gym. And then in October on the 17th, we have the Energy Awareness 5K. So all you runners, get your shoes on. All you non-runners, get your shoes on and give it a try. Get out there and do the 5Ks. If you have a pet that you take to the vet clinic, the clinic is going to be closed the 26th through the 28th. That's in order so they can do their annual inventory. So if Rover gets a cold or Fluffy coughs up a fur ball, you're going to need to take them somewhere else on those days. The vet clinic isn't going to be open. All right, on the 28th, this will make all the school kids happy. This Friday, early dismissal for all DoDEA schools on Friday. So the shouts of joy will be coming from the kids. The cries of anguish will be coming from the parents. So but remember, the DoDEA schools will be releasing early. And coming up on the 13th of October is the 237th Navy Ball. Tickets are on sale now. That'll be over at Purdy Gym. We take up the entire second floor with both the gyms. We can anticipate as many as 1,000 people coming to the Navy Ball this year, so get your tickets now. And also, if you have children, the Yokosuka CDC will be open special hours that evening from 5 p.m. till midnight. So you can drop your kids off at CDC and then go to the Navy Ball. On the 21st of October will be the Mikoshi Parade. That's when the Mikoshis get carried from downtown Yokosuka, and it finishes up here on the base. CFAY has its own Mikoshi, and we're looking for volunteers. It does earn Captain Cup points for your command, so sign up. You got to go to the rehearsal, and you can help carry the Mikoshi and get Captain's Cup points. Also, speaking of Captain's Cup, the Co-Rec Soccer Tournament is coming up on the 1st of October, so commands, get your teams together, get out there. Subgroup 7 is leading in all categories again this year. We got to get out there. We got to dethrone them so we can. I don't have to listen to the mouth that can't be ignored, Lauren over there harassing me about how Subgroup 7 wins all the Captain Cup events. We've got coming up next week is homecoming week at the high school. That's a good lead into some of the guests I'm going to have on here pretty soon. The 1st through the 5th, they're going to have all sorts of homecoming events going on. And on the 6th, it's going to be the homecoming parade. And they're going to have the homecoming football game that evening against the team from Seoul. So all those, be ready for the Kinnick, and let's go Red Devils, get out there. And finally, before we go to the break here, the Yokosuka Bay Stars, the minor league team of the Yokohama Bay Stars that play in Apama, are just about ready to finish up their season. Here's your last chance to go catch yourself a game. It's only 1,000 yen to get in and a couple train stations away from Shiori. They play on the 28th, the 29th, and their final game of the season is on this Sunday, the 30th of September. So if you haven't seen a Japanese professional baseball game and you'd like to, they got a really nice stadium over there in Apama. Here's your chance. We're going to take a quick break, and I'll be right back.
Let's go! Hey, Jack! On behalf of Kinnick High School, we would like to welcome you to our 2012 Homecoming Week from October 1st to October 6th.
On October 1st, Monday, it's Pajama Day. Come as cozy and as comfortable as you want.
Aloha. Tuesday is Hawaiian Tourist Day. Make sure you bring your camera and your favorite Hawaiian t-shirt. Mahalo.
Wednesday is Twin Day.
Find a friend.
And wear matching clothes with them.
Thursday, October 4th is Back to Kindergarten Day. So wear your favorite overalls and bring your favorite lunchbox.
And on Friday, it's Spirit Day. Come dressed in red and white. Woo!
Everyone, remember to follow all dress codes and have a great homecoming week. Woo!
Okay, welcome back, CFAY. Like I said, I was going to have some special guests on the show, and sure enough, they're here right now. I've got the president and the vice president of the student council for Kinnick High School with me. Welcome to the show this morning, ladies.
Thank you. Thank you.
What's your name?
I'm Sheila, student council president.
Okay, and?
I'm Aiko Allen, student council vice president.
All right, cool. They're here to talk to us a little bit about the homecoming events that will be happening next week. What can you tell me what's going to be set up for homecoming?
All right, so next week is Spirit Week for Homecoming Week. And Monday is Pajama Day, where students can wear pajamas and they can bring pillows, blankets, or stuffed animals.
Does that mean they get to sleep through class?
No.
No?
We wish.
No. But on that day, we have a barbecue after school, which will be around 5:30 after practice, to open up homecoming week for everyone.
Okay, cool.
On Tuesday, we will have Hawaiian Tourist Day, where students dress like Hawaiian tourists, and they can bring cameras, hats, sunglasses, Hawaiian t-shirts. It's really cool.
Okay, all right.
Also on that day, we have a game where teachers, they give us their high school pictures, and we put them around school, and kids, they guess which teacher is which.
Do all the teachers even have high school pictures?
Some do. Some have. Some have been emailing us.
Some have them, not all of them have them?
Yeah.
There's a couple of them so old they didn't even have
pictures. Yeah. But on Wednesday, we have Twin Day, where students just dress in similar clothes as someone else. So
you're going to dress like her and she's going to dress like you or something like that?
Yeah. Also on Wednesday after school is Powder Puff game where girls play football and guys cheer.
Okay, is it, what is it, the seniors against the juniors or how do they
It's
that?
Usually seniors against freshmen, then juniors against sophomores.
Also, there's going to be two games.
Yeah.
How do they pick the guys that are going to be the cheerleaders? Is it by talent or
just by volunteers?
Okay.
Yeah. And then the day after that, on Thursday, we have Back to Kindergarten Day. And girls can wear, like, little kids' shirts, and they can do their hair in a style like pigtails. Boys can wear collared shirts, they can wear kitty backpacks, and they can bring lunch bags.
Okay, all right, cool.
And then our game for that day is a breakfast walk in the morning.
Okay.
It's like a musical chair where people walk around. We'll have certain numbers on the chair, and then we'll play music. And once the music stops, kids will sit on the chairs and... If they say on certain numbers and we pick out that number, then they get a free breakfast.
All right, cool. Free breakfast. Gotta like that.
Yeah. On Friday, the final day of Spirit Week, we have Spirit Day, which is where the classes dress in their colors. Like for freshmen, we have yellow. For sophomores, we have blue. For juniors, we have green. And for seniors, we have the Ojai red.
Okay, I would hope so. The seniors get to wear the school colors.
And on that day, we have our pep rally. And also the homecoming dance, which is from 7 to 10.
Homecoming dance that night?
Yes.
Isn't the football players going to get tired from the dance when they got to play the next day?
That's why we're putting it from 7 to 10.
Okay, all right. Okay, I better not hear no excuses for football. They didn't play well on Saturday because they were dancing too late on
this. Okay, so on Saturday is the game and the parade. The JV game starts at 12, and varsity starts at 4. And the parade starts at 2:30.
So the parade is in between the two games?
In between JV and varsity.
All right. Well, lots of stuff going on out there. It sounds like it's going to be a good time. You ladies have anything else you'd like to add? Or does that about cover it?
Yeah. Oh, if anyone has like a convertible.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Because we need convertibles for the parade. So if anyone has a convertible and is willing to lend us or let us borrow during homecoming, it would be much appreciated.
Who drives the convertibles?
They can drive it.
Yeah.
They can drive their own convertible. Yeah. So if anybody wants to get involved in the parade, you got a convertible, you can come out and drive the convertible, put whoever they're going to put in them in there. I think I'm supposed to be in one of them this year, but don't throw tomatoes at that convertible because it's not my convertible, okay? All right.
Again, thank you, ladies, for being
thank
on
you.
The show.
Thank
Lots
you.
Of stuff going on. We're going to take another quick break, then I'm going to have another special guest. All right, CFAY, I'm back again, and I got another special guest on the show. And who do I got here?
I'm Dustin Wilson.
Dustin Wilson. You should recognize that name because he was last week's Stars and Stripes Athlete of the Week, was he not?
Yes.
All right, pretty cool. You play on the football team?
Yes, sir.
All right, what position you play?
I play quarterback.
He's the quarterback. He's the one that helps scores us all those touchdowns. And, Dustin, I understand you got something to give me here today.
Yes, sir. I got you the KHS and Zama SmackDown paddle.
SmackDown paddle!
Here you go, sir.
All right. And for those who don't know, what me and the CO from Itsugi decided on, we come up with a little symbol whenever Kinnick plays Zama up at Itsugi, because the Itsugi kids go to Zama High School. And the winning team, whoever wins, that base CO gets to keep the symbol in his office for that year, and we called it the SmackDown paddle. And this is the first inaugural year of it, and the SmackDown paddle is come to CFAY. We managed to win that game, so it is going to be in my office for the next year, and it's going to be up to Dustin and his fellow football players to make sure it stays there for a long, long time. All right, you looking forward to homecoming?
Yes, sir.
You got a homecoming date?
Yes, sir.
You do? you know. I give this advice about prom, and I'll tell you the same home thing. It's smarter to go stag. You know why?
Why?
Because you can dance with everybody else's dates, and you don't have to go home with the one that brought you. You know? I mean, come on now. This would be pretty cool. Don't you think that? You're a good-looking guy. You probably could dance with more than one gal, can't you? At one time? Yeah, look at that. Oh, yeah, cool. Now, don't dance too much on Friday night, though, because you got to play football on Saturday. How many touchdowns are you going to score?
I'm thinking about three.
Three? Three for the homecoming game?
Yes, sir.
You heard it here first. The quarterback has called it out that he's going to score three touchdowns against Seoul on the 6th of October. So I'll be there counting the touchdowns. If you throw an interception, you're going to CAF and you're going to do community service. I just want you to know that right now. All right. Well, thank you for having been here. I'm going to go ahead and go into the trivia. Dustin can sit here and laugh at my trivia questions while we do it if he wants. Maybe he can even answer a couple. But keep your answers to yourself. We don't want to give it away. All right. From my last show. The TV show I was looking for was The Brady Bunch. Marcia was the one who got her nose broken by the football. And two people gave me the answer for that, Summer Johnston and Frances Simpson. So thank you for those answers. One of the songs I was looking for was Beach Boys, Be True to Your School. And Brianna, I hope I don't mess this up, Brianna Fredenberg, I think is how it is said, Fredenberg. And the sport question I was looking for was, who attempted the longest field goal? Didn't make it, but what was the longest field goal attempt in the NFL? It was something like 70 yards. It was attempted by Sebastian Janikowski. He didn't make it. He tried, though. And again, it was Brianna Fredenberg who gave me the answer to that, so thank you. For the new trivia questions, here's the song. I actually used this one last time, but nobody answered it. So here's the lyrics. See if you can tell me what the group or the artist is. I thought it was forever. I thought it would last. Got to try to make it a page of my past. All right, so that one's out there still. The movie I'm looking for, this 1985 film follows five students at a fictional high school called Shermer High School. What's the movie? See if you can figure out what the movie is. That one shouldn't be too hard. And the sports question, recently the Arkansas Razorbacks had the second largest fall in college poll history. They dropped from like 8 completely out of the polls. Well, that begs the question then, what college team had the largest drop? It only happened about 2-3 years ago, fell completely out of the polls from the highest position in the polls. Which team was that? Well, as usual, CFAY, I hope everybody stays safe. And a reminder that good shipmates don't let shipmates drink and drive. Good shipmates don't let shipmates do drugs. And good shipmates don't let shipmates get sexually assaulted. Go Red Devils and have a great week.